Maxon Studio is a revolutionary tool for browsing, applying, and editing what we call capsules, which are essentially a more intelligent, more powerful, more efficient version of templates. In addition to an ever-expanding library of professionally designed capsules, free for all subscribers, you can now create your own capsules from right here in the new Create page. This allows you to not only bring the power and automation of capsules to your own workflow, but also to easily share them with others. This allows others on your team, or your millions of devoted internet fans, to easily tweak parameters that you choose in amounts that you specify, as well as create their own presets for your capsules. Let's see how easy this is to set up. I have three compositions in this project: an empty composition, a very simple animation, and some titles for a film. We'll start with the very simple animation just so it's very clear how easy this process is. Then we'll look at a more advanced example. I could go to the window menu to launch Maxon Studio, but I prefer using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Alt+Space, which is the same on both Mac and Windows. Here in the Discover page, we browse and apply capsules. We edit them in the Edit page, and now there's another button, the Create page, to create our own capsules. From this page, we can also see other capsules we've created, get info on capsule creation, import other capsules, and more. I'm going to click the New button to begin the process of creating a new capsule. Whoops, this isn't the right composition. This was just the last composition I had selected when describing the project, so Studio assumes that this is the one that I want to use. Now, without closing this dialog box, I'm going to instead select the very simple animation comp and then click this refresh button. There we go. When first creating this capsule, we're brought to the details tab of the create page. Here we can name our capsule, input details about its authorship, searchable keywords, and more. Also note that Studio uses whatever frame we were currently on as a thumbnail by default. To choose a new thumbnail for your capsule, move to the frame you'd like and then click the camera icon. If necessary, resize your Studio window or click on the Controls tab in order to see the Controls area. This is where we'll add the parameters we'd like to access from the Edit page when our capsule is applied. To add parameters, they must first be exposed in the After Effects timeline panel. This is critically important. Only properties that can be exposed in the After Effects timeline panel can be adjusted here in Studio. Then you could simply drag and drop the properties into the controls area. Our controls can be organized in several different ways, such as with groups. To edit the name of this group, click the pencil icon next to the name group 1 that shows up when you hover your mouse over it. I'll call this group star and then hit enter or return to accept the changes, or I could click in a blank area in the Studio interface, like here, for example. Now we have an organized group and can put all star related content in here. In my timeline panel, I'll select the star layer and press the T key on my keyboard to reveal its opacity. Drag and drop the word opacity from the timeline panel into this area in the controls of the create page. And that's it. The opacity of the star can now be controlled from either the timeline panel or from right here in Studio. We don't even need to finish creating the capsule. This functionality makes it so the Studio can be used as a way to manage and edit complicated projects quickly, even when you're not setting out to create a capsule. Next, I'll go back to the timeline panel and press the S key to reveal its scale property. Then I can drag and drop this scale property as we did before. Note that when I hover my mouse over these properties, we can see a stopwatch, indicating that they can be animated from the convenience of this window as well. Now, if someone adjusts this capsule later, I don't want them getting carried away with the scale of this star. So I'm going to click on the scale property to highlight it. This allows me to adjust its values in the properties tab. Now, I don't want anyone accidentally inverting this either, so I'm going to set a minimum limit of 0 for both the X and Y axis. I also don't want anyone going crazy on making this too big either, so I'm going to set maximum scale values of 120. Now, if a user drags this value, it can't go below 0 into negative numbers or above 120. I actually want the scale property on top of the opacity property. Using these little arrows on the left side, I can click to reorder parameters as needed. Next, I want to add parameters related to my text, so I'll make a new group and name it text. In my timeline panel, I'll select the type and press the letter U 2 times, UU, in order to reveal the properties I've changed from their defaults, which will reveal the source text property. When I drag this to my new text group in Studio, you'll see that I can now change the text from right here and make the text as rebellious and naughty as I please. Let me show you one of my favorite features in the Create page. I'm going to create a new group and call it Global Controls. What I want to do is control the glow settings on both the text and the star at the same time. These glow effects are on two different layers, but Studio allows us to link properties together so that multiple parameters with similar controls can be controlled at the same time. To the right of the global controls, we have a couple important icons. We can click the trash can to trash the whole group and all its parameters. And next to the trash can, we can click this icon to access this category of helpers. From here, we can add organizational tools such as labels, comments, or dividers within groups. Or we can add one of these other elements as a controller. I'm going to choose slider, which will create an empty slider that essentially doesn't do anything. I'm going to rename this slider glow amount, and then I'm going to use this one slider to control the glow on both the star and the text at the same time. I'll select the star layer, and in the optical glow effect in the effect controls panel, I can double click a parameter such as the amount to have it reveal in the timeline panel. And now I can just drag and drop it into Studio. In this case, I want to drag it into the glow amount slider's linked parameters area. Then I'll do the exact same thing for the text layer. And while I'm here, I'll just go ahead and set the slider minimum to 0 and the slider maximum to 10, just to discourage others from going a little too crazy with the glow. Now, this one slider will control the glow amount on both layers at the same time. We can add more parameters linked to this control if we want to as well. Note that you don't need this special controller to link parameters. Selecting any property we've added previously, you can see in the Properties tab that we can link any properties with similar controls. Change multiple colors on multiple layers in multiple compositions with a single color swatch. Resize or rotate multiple layers at once. Now, the last thing in this new capsule is that we have a footage item, this photo of a beach. Currently, assets cannot be stored in Studio Capsules, but I like this design with a blend mode and lowered opacity and want to give those who use this capsule the ability to automatically apply these adjustments to their own images. For that, we need to create a placeholder. To create a placeholder, you can create a placeholder object as we did with the slider, or you can simply drag and drop an asset from the timeline panel to here in Studio. Then later, once your capsule is applied, users can simply go to the Edit Capsules page and drag and drop their own footage in order to swap out your placeholder for their content, all while retaining the opacity, scale, blend mode, and other adjustments we made. In order to finish this capsule and create it, we need to first go to the Details tab and ensure that we've named this and added any keywords that we need, and then we can click the Create button. Studio will tell us when the capsule was created successfully, and then it will show up in the Create page as one of the capsules we've made, as well as in our Discover page. You can find your own capsules easily by either searching its keywords or by changing the filter to My Capsules. Note that before creating your capsule, the actual work of building your capsule is stored inside the After Effects project. But once you create it, then it is stored inside of Maxon Studio and is independent of any project. Also, once it's saved, you've got all kinds of options. I can click the three dots here to do things like rename it, make a duplicate, delete it, or export it. And then to import exported capsules, just click here in the Create page. And we'll look in a moment at how to modify capsules after they've been created. Also note though that however your composition looks when you create the capsule is how it will look when the capsule is applied by users later. Most capsules that ship with Studio apply a nice, tidy, nested composition. But I wanted you to be able to see what I was doing. So my comp was this sloppy mess when I created it, which means that it's going to be this same sloppy mess when users apply it. Now that we've learned the basics of capsule creation, let's briefly look at a more complex example. I wanted to create titles for a fictional spy movie. For this, I actually started with this existing capsule in Maxon Studio, created by Andy Needham, because that's the power of Studio. You can even use existing capsules as building blocks to create new ones. So I took Andy's capsule and added a few effects here, some text, some stylizations to make it feel more filmic, and these black bars to create a 2:4:0 aspect ratio. I wanted users to be able to change the color of this text, but remember that you can only edit things in Studio that can be adjusted in the timeline panel. And the color of text cannot by default be edited in the timeline panel. So to get around this, I applied a fill effect to my text layers and then brought those color parameters into Studio so users could edit them from the edit page. I also wanted users to be able to turn on and off the 2:4:0 aspect ratio bars. I could always just use the opacity property to do this, but in this case, and actually often in Studio, I want to give users the ability to turn layers on and off. I can do this with expressions. I first created a null layer and applied the checkbox control effect to it. This is just meant to be a controller for expressions. Then for the opacity property of the layers I wanted to turn on and off, I created this simple expression that basically says that if the checkbox is checked, use an opacity value of 100. If it is unchecked, then it returns an opacity value of 0. So after setting this up, the checkbox control effect on the null can turn the layer on and off. Then I create a checkbox controller in Studio and drag and drop the checkbox control from the timeline panel into Studio. Now this layer has an on-off switch. I did the same thing for the film styling effects. Note that one of the coolest secret features of Maxon Studio is that it's a world traveler. If you give an After Effects project using expressions to someone using a different language of After Effects, those expressions usually will break. But when you use expressions in Maxon Studio, Studio will recognize the language differences and automatically translate the expressions in the capsule for you so that everything is compatible. Notice that this capsule that we're working on has already been created, but what if we want to change it after it's been created? No problem. Just locate the created capsule and click the blue modify button on either the main thumbnail or here in the details area. This will load your original project so you can make adjustments as needed. I'm going to create a new adjustment layer and apply magic bullet looks to it. Many effects, such as Magic Bullet Looks, Real Lens Flare, Super Comp, the Designer and Trapcode Particular, these effects have a pop-up window of some kind. Now, these effects can all be used in Studio Capsules. However, because these custom windows don't exist in the timeline panel, they cannot be edited directly in the edit page in Studio. But again, they can be used in Capsules and then edited directly as normal in After Effects. Note that other third-party effects can also be used in the creation of Maxon Studio capsules, just like with the other effects and parameters we've seen in this video. Once you're done modifying the capsule, click the Create button. I'm going to choose to replace the previous capsule with this new and improved version, and that's it. For more information and updates on creating capsules, check the info button in the Create page. We here at Maxon are so excited to see the brilliant things you do with this new ability to create capsules. Thanks for watching.